I'm Kaveri Sena Nayaka, an undergraduate physiotherapy student from Department of Allied Health Sciences, Faculty of Medicine, University of Colombo, Sri Lanka. Our research topic is effects of obesity on food outcomes in women with plantar fasciitis. Plantar fasciitis is the most common foot condition treated by physiotherapists and ankle and foot specialists worldwide. It accounts about 40% of all the foot conditions. The plantar heel pain is the most common presentation of plantar fasciitis, and plantar heel pain limits activities of daily living and quality of life. Obesity is a known factor to reduce prognosis of many diseases, and evidence is unclear on how obesity affects women with plantar fasciitis. Therefore, the general objective of our study was to identify the effects of obesity on foot outcomes in women with plantar fasciitis. We conducted a cross-sectional study enrolling 54 women with unilateral plantar fasciitis who attending for physiotherapy treatments in departments of rheumatology and rehabilitation, special and general of National Hospital of Sri Lanka. We excluded women with arthritic conditions, deformities, surgeries and fractures, and women with neurological problems that affect walking during the last 6 months. And we divided the participants into three groups as obese, overweight and non-overweight, depending on their BMI values. The mean age of participants was 46.17. When it comes to the data collection tools, to assess the quality of life, we use SF36 questionnaire. The foot function index questionnaire was used to assess the foot pain, disability, and activity restrictions associated with plantar fasciitis. Foot arc height, ankle dorsiflexion range, and calf endurance were measured using arc index, weight-bearing lunge test, and calf erasers test, respectively. A handheld dynamometer was used to measure the ankle dorsiflexors and plantar flexors strength. If you look at our main study findings, the three BMI groups showed significant difference between SF36 score, foot function index score, weight-bearing lunge test distance, and ankle dorsiflexors strength. But BMI groups did not show significant difference between calf erasers, plantar flexors strength, and arc index. The SF36 score, ankle dorsiflexion range, and ankle dorsiflexion strength showed significant negative correlation with BMI values, but the foot function index showed a positive correlation with the BMI values. After considering our results, we can interpret that the quality of life, ankle dorsiflexion range, and ankle dorsiflexor strength decreased with higher BMI values in women with plantar fasciitis, but the foot pain, disability, and activity restrictions associated with plantar fasciitis increase significantly women with higher BMI values. Thank you all for listening to my presentation.